acre here. If we keep headed on this vector, we're going to be sitting ducks. I'm now disabling the autopilot computer and switching to manual overdrive. Computer off.
Cadet Baker, this is Major General Hunter.
Yes, sir, I copy you.
Listen, Hotshot, get back on autopilot. This is a combat formation, Baker. You're to re-engage the computer and keep your eyes on the radar screen. Is that understood?
Sir, these scanners are worthless.
Baker, did you hear me?
Yes, sir, just a second, sir. I've spotted the enemy. Missiles away! Contact with you, sir. Are you somewhere out there? Come in, General.
Affirmative. I'm here, but not for long.
You've been hit, General.
You've a gift for recognizing the obvious, Baker.
Enemy incoming, converging on our position from Vector 15. I'll draw them away. Once I've lost them, I'll come back for you, sir.
Negative, Cadet. You're to remain with the squadron. Repeat, remain with the squadron.
But, sir, I can't.
I've lost primary thrusters. I'm gonna have to ditch her. Tell Lisa that I...
The general's last orders were lost in static. I'm going after it. Let's see what this pea shooter can do. Kicked in. That's got her back on track. Well, let's see. He must have ditched around here someplace. I told you I'd come after you, sir.
Are you all right, General Hunter?
Forget about me. Get back to the squadron. This sector's crawling with enemy units.
I'm sorry, sir. I can't just leave you bobbing around out here.
Uh-oh, trouble. They've got me surrounded.
Battle scenario terminated. Mission failure at level 21A. Deactivate holograph and restore systems to default mode. Cadet Baker to report to staging area for results and analysis of exercise. System crew, prepare the simulator for the next candidate.
Not the smoothest performance, but you gotta admit that Baker's got something.
Yeah, but I'm not sure it's something I like.
General, the cadet is waiting in the staging area.
Cadet Baker reporting as ordered, sir.
At ease.
Sir, I know my performance wasn't perfect and the mission was a failure, but that test wasn't a fair demonstration of my abilities.
In the first place, you went off autopilot contrary to orders. Second, by doing so, you endangered the entire squadron. And third, you didn't even manage to rescue me. Dismissed.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I appreciate your input, sir.
It's funny. He reminds me of a certain amateur pilot I once knew, name of Hunter.
I guess he does have a certain reckless sense of style about him.
I suppose that explains why you were so rough on him?
I'm just trying to make him a better fighter pilot. Besides, the look on his face was priceless.
Final preparations are proceeding on schedule. We should have no problems meeting our launch window. If we are to avoid a second Robotech war, we must make peaceful contact with the Robotech Masters and establish a relationship of mutual cooperation. That is the mission of the SDF-3.
I want to take this opportunity to re-emphasize that the Robotech Expeditionary Force is intended as a diplomatic mission. The SDF-3 will be traveling to the homeworld of the Robotech Masters, the third moon of the planet Phantoma known as Tyrone. The Masters themselves have not engaged in actual combat for nearly six generations. However, it is impossible to predict with certainty how they will react to our mission. For that reason, the SDF-3 is being outfitted with a considerable arsenal of Robotech weaponry. In the event that we are met with force, we shall be ready and able to defend ourselves. I must stress the fact that the departure of the expedition will not leave the Earth undefended. General Leonard and his staff have already begun rebuilding the Robotech defense forces, And as the planet is not presently threatened by any enemy, we feel confident that the Earth is in no danger.
If I may interrupt for a moment, I'm not as optimistic as the ambassador about the lack of an enemy threat. Mark my words, the departure of the STF-3 and its weapon systems will leave the Earth hopelessly vulnerable to attack.
Gentlemen, please.
It's all very easy for him to say we're safe. When the attack comes, he'll be on the other side of the galaxy.
Frankly, I think you're a bit paranoid, General. What attack do you mean? By whom? From where?
For all we know, there could be a fleet of your fellows in Trotty out there just waiting for us to drop
off, General.
But, gentlemen, you're gutting our defenses. Once the STF leaves orbit, I won't be able to defend the Earth from a flock of pigeons.
Oh, good grief. Come on, Lisa. Hurry it up, will you? How much time does it take to try on a wedding dress?
Just a minute. Oh, there. Not too shabby for an admiral of the fleet, if I do say so myself. Just think, 2 more days and I'll be a married woman. At last. How could I have ever been jealous of Minmay?
What's keeping her? Do you think maybe she's picking out baby clothes, too?
Come on, let her enjoy the moment while she can. A few days from now, we may be in the middle of an intergalactic war. A swell way to spend your honeymoon. Oh, hey, cut it out! Why'd you do that?
I didn't do anything. Your brain's just getting smaller.
Whose brain's getting smaller?
Okay, I admit it. I'm guilty. Guess I can't pull the wool over your eyes.
What do you think?
Oh.
Well?
I think you picked a beauty, Admiral. That gown is shipshape from stem to stern.
But will it go from zero to hyperspace in 5 seconds?
Oh, you too.
Excuse me.
You?
I know I'm interrupting. I'm sorry. But as soon as I heard the news, I hopped the first shuttle I could find and came to see if I could be any help. That is, if you'd allow me to, Lisa.
Minmay, this is all so unexpected. But don't be silly. Of course you can help. Come here.
Oh, Lisa, I want so much for us to let bygones be bygones. That dress is lovely. I always knew you'd make a beautiful bride.
You look lovely indeed, Admiral.
I still think she should get married in her space suit.
Holy.
Oh, cut out, Dana. Oh. Why do you keep doing that?
Oh, Minmay, I can't tell you what it means to see you again.
Children.
That devious little Centrati has got the whole Supreme Council eating out of his hand. It's unbelievable. A diplomatic mission. If it's a diplomatic mission, then why are they arming that ship with every Robotech weapon system we've ever developed?
It's called gunboat diplomacy.
Well, stupidity's what I call it. It jeopardizes the very survival of this planet. Something stinks here, Commander, and it's not in the ventilation system.
All station chiefs, please report for final mission briefing.
Meanwhile, far, far away, a very different sort of mission has arrived above the third moon of Phantoma.
Whoever they are, they've landed near our mining colony.
Look, Cabell, there must be hundreds of them. What will we do? With the Robotech masters away, we're unable to strike back. Only the old and the sick remain on Tyrol.
They're transport vessels of some kind. They're unloading something. I'll try to get an energy fix.
Don't bother. Look at the monitor.
The transport vessels are returning to their fleet. Now, what could they have in mind?
Frankly, Cabell, I'm a lot more concerned about these monsters they've left behind.
They resemble machines, actually, not monsters.
Well, whatever they are, one of them just spotted our remote.
I am beginning to suspect who this invader is, and heaven help us if I'm right.
They're headed straight for the mining colony at Rylak. Shouldn't we warn the outpost there? I can make contact.
No, we mustn't give our visitors a clue to our whereabouts. The men at Rylak will have to fend for themselves.
Getting a brainstorm.
Maybe you've been out in the sun too long.
No, listen.
Those jokers are coming right down the center of the ravine. Now, if you were to take a shot at that rock face on the far side...
Yeah, I could bring the whole cliff down on top of their heads.
You get one shot. Make it count, all right?
Trust me.
We did it. We got every last one of them.
What the?
Maybe not. What is that?
Stay back, Zeb. I'll take care of these things.
My suspicion's correct. There is only one species capable of producing such a device.
The Invid?
Yes. The strategy is typical of them. The Invid often deploy mechanized fighting drones such as these to clear away resistance before they themselves descend to the planet's surface. These machines are incredibly complex and essentially invulnerable to any direct attack.
Then what you are saying is that our cause is hopeless.
I'm not saying that at all, my boy. Be patient. Here is the cat-like drone we saw earlier. Like its two-legged counterpart, it is an inorganic, computer-driven device, incapable of independent action. Therefore, its functions must be controlled by an external, centralized power source of some kind. And that is its weak spot. That is the one flaw in the system, and it's up to us to take advantage of it.
Cabell, what are you talking about?
Is it not easier to attack one target than 1,000? If we find that power source and disable it, then all the dreaded machines of the Invid will collapse like so much scrap metal.
Do you think we could?
Anything is possible.
Slowing them down. They've overrun our positions all along the front.
Of course they have. Our Bioroids are hopelessly outnumbered.
They'll be in the capital in a matter of hours.
Attention, flagship. Royal Shuttle 1 right upon the approach. Understood, Shuttle. You are clear for docking in main hangar bay. My lord, the inorganics have met only token resistance on Tyrol. So far, there is no sign of the Robotech masters.
Cowering beneath their beds, no doubt.
Our beloved Regis has expressed some displeasure with your strategy, my lord. She ordered this to be given to you.
A voice imprint? How thoughtful of my wife. I can hardly wait to hear it.
Do you truly believe that you'll find what you seek on this wretched planet? If so, you are a greater fool than I ever suspected. This idiotic invasion of yours is the most...
I think I've heard about enough of that for the moment. Tell me, where is our beloved Regis?
She has returned to her flagship, my lord.
Negative. The farther away she is, the better I like it. The invasion will proceed without her.
As the Invid plot to destroy the last strongholds of resistance on the homeworld of the Robotech Masters, a group of brave Earthborn warriors must face resistance of a different sort. Resistance born from nearly 10 years of inactivity and overconfidence. But within the coming week, the Robotech Expeditionary Force will embark on a mission to the distant star system of the Southern Cross and will once again be placed in a situation which will pit man and machine against an unknown enemy.
Command shuttle standing by for transit to orbiting repair factory.
Shuttle passengers now boarding at Bay 5.
Please await. Tell me, is there something on Rick's mind? He's been very moody for a couple of days now.
Don't ask me. I'm only his fiancée, not his psychiatrist.
There you are, Professor. I've been looking all over the ship for you. Have any idea what the matter is with Rick? He's been moping around all morning.
Good grief, man. Don't ask me. I'm only the mission leader. I'm not his shrink. Remember, we are about to embark on an expedition to the farthest boundaries of the universe. It's enough to make anybody nervous.
Control, this is Mission Command. Shuttle reports Dr. Lang and his team are now on board.
All our systems show ready. You are cleared for departure, Mission Command.
Shuttle now on approach to Robotech Repair Factory. Docking will take place in 15 minutes.
I hope this plan of yours works, Exidor. Disguising the SDF-3 as his Entradi battlecruiser has always seemed like a pretty radical step to me.
Oh, you're forgetting your own Earth history, Colonel. The Greeks and their Trojan horse.
Don't confuse history with mythology, Exidor. You'll never win an argument that way.
Gentlemen, the time is long past when arguments about strategy would have any practical effect on our mission. We've all supported this plan, and it seems rather late in the day to be changing our minds.
Well, from where I sit, it seems like the perfect way to approach their planet.
But will the Robotech Masters buy it? What happens if they're able to penetrate our outward appearance and discover we're from Earth? You've got to admit, things could get pretty uncomfortable.
It's possible, but if we let possibilities stop us, we'd never leave orbit.
We've made our bed, now we have to sleep in it. I'm the military commander of this expedition, and I guess I have as many doubts as anybody. But now, gentlemen, the time has come to put them behind us. Brave talk, Hunter. But you know there's some doubts you just can't brush aside. I've no doubts that I love Lisa, but do I deserve her? And what right do I have to command all these people? It seems like only yesterday that we were both so young. Don't worry, Lisa. I'm all right. Just more than I can say for Loverboy here. Lisa! Lisa, are you... What is it? Are you all right?
I'm so frightened.
It's over. Why are you frightened?
Because for the first time in my life, I realized... Rick, I'd be lost without you.
I wonder, Lisa. Sometimes I wonder if you wouldn't be better off without me. But we've been through so much together, Lisa. Somehow, through all the adventures, the good times and the bad, it always came back to us, you and me. I guess that must mean something. Like maybe we were meant for each other.
Well, at least she's keeping up her appearance. With all the launch preparations going on, I was afraid we might have to remind her that she's about to get married.
That's one thing the Admiral won't forget.
Mom, why are we whispering? Is Lisa and Rick's wedding supposed to be a secret or something?
All right, everyone, come in. I can see I've had about as much privacy as I'm going to get today.
Come on, Lisa, don't be selfish. Best friends don't get married every day.
That's right, especially if they happen to be an admiral of the fleet. We just came by to make sure your feet aren't planted too firmly on the ground, Lisa.
Don't worry, girls. I'm as nervous as any bride-to-be ever was. Oh, did you see the ring Rick gave me?
No, let's see it. I've always wondered what sort of money a Major General makes.
I may be biased, but I think it's beautiful.
I've got to admit it, I'm impressed.
Mom, I still don't get it. How can Lisa be Rick's wife? I thought he already had one.
Dana, I think you've got him confused with somebody else.
But Mom says he's married to his job.
As you know, I am Zentradi, and I need hardly remind you, gentlemen, that for many years my people served the Robotech Masters as mercenaries. As a biogenetic experiment that backfired, we were given a unique opportunity to study their behavior. These are not monsters, my friends. In fact, the majority of them are as peace-loving as you or I.
Starting tomorrow, Major General Hunter will be selecting his crew for the expedition. He'll want pilots who know the Alpha schematics backwards and forwards.
Too much paperwork.
Baker, that paperwork will decide whether you go on this mission or spend the rest of your career mopping slop in an orbital ball bearing factory.
I don't suppose you know much about Rick Hunter, do you?
No, sir.
You're a little young to remember the first Robotech War.
I know he's our most decorated hero.
That's right, they give you a medal if you're lucky enough to be in the right place at the right time.
Colonel Edwards, it sounds to me like you've got a bone to pick with him.
You bet I have, Benson. I'm going to do everything in my power to bring that flyboy down to Earth, and I'm expecting you to back me up.
There it is, the Robotech factory. The last time I visited that tub, I had to sneak on board.
Those were the days.
I'll never forget the look on the faces of those Centrati when Miria showed them baby Dana. It was like they'd never seen one before.
They're all clones, Max. I suppose they never had.
I guess not. But then Dana'd never seen a clone before. You didn't see her going all to pieces.
Attention all stations. Shuttle 1 from Mission Command, now docking at Hangar Bay 6. Command level representatives from all departments report to hangar area immediately.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Colonel Reinhardt. I'd like to welcome you all to the ship. You see before you a splendid piece of engineering, if I do say so myself. We used absolutely everything salvageable from the SDF 1 and 2.
Then wrapped the whole thing up in the exoskeleton of a Centrati battlecruiser.
Our new allies, Britai and Exidor, were a great help with the details. We think it's quite a convincing imitation.
I'll say it is. Kind of brings back some bad memories of the first Robotech War.
You'll excuse me for playing devil's advocate here, but I hope we're not forgetting something. This ship has to do more than look pretty. Are you sure it can get us there and back in one piece?
It will, Colonel Wolf. Don't worry.
Colonel Reinhardt, we all remember what happened when the original SDF made its first attempt at jumping through hyperspace. The ship took a large piece of your planet along with it. I'm sure none of us wants to repeat that little phenomenon.
Your comrade Britai's been over the plans with the engineer.
Come to think of it, what's happened to Britai? His last communication made it clear he planned to meet us here. Do you think maybe he forgot we were coming in?
He's probably just too busy to get here.
Well, I'm afraid we'll have to continue our tour without him for the moment. We've got a lot of details to attend to, and our launch window is approaching.
Britai!
Well, well, so I'm not important enough to wait for. You Micronians are so impatient.
I almost didn't recognize you. What happened? Did you shrink?
In a word, yes. Dr. Lang thought I'd fit in better with everyone if I was micronized, and he designed this new faceplate for me to wear at the wedding.
Here you see the home system of the Robotech Masters. The central planet, Phantoma, is extremely large, approximately the size of Jupiter. Its third moon, Tyrol, is where the civilization of the Robotech Masters evolved. As you know, they developed, with the help of a scientist named Zor, the energy system called Robotechnology, and used it in an attempt to control the known universe.
But at this moment, the Tyresians known as Ram and Cabell are unable to control even their own destiny. They watch in helpless fury as their homeworld is brutally ravaged by the relentless, inorganic servants of the Invid.
The flower of life,
That's what they've come for.
That must be it. They've come searching for the flower of life, the primary catalyst in the production of protoculture. But that plant hasn't been present in this system ever since the Robotech Masters left.
It was a Robotech Master named Zor that stole the flower from the Invid. It was only a matter of time before they came here looking for it.
What madness! They're ripping the whole planet apart looking for something they'll never find.
No one ever accused the Invid of being logical, only thorough.
I'm beginning to think it's hopeless, Cabell. Those drones are unstoppable, it seems.
Nonsense. They may be intimidating, my boy, but they are not unstoppable. Even the most complex machine has a weak spot.
Then by all means, let's find it. What are we waiting for?
My people owe their very existence to the Robotech Masters. We Zentradi were developed as an offshoot of robotechnology. We are the result of an experiment in biogenetic engineering. An experiment quite advanced for its time.
Are the Robotech Masters as physically big as your people were at one time?
No, surprisingly, they're about the same size as you.
So you supplied them with their muscle power?
You mean the Zentradi were just the brawns for someone else's brains? No wonder they seem so dumb.
They came about as close as you can come to blasting the Earth back into the Stone Age. That's how dumb they are. I suggest you keep your opinions to yourself from now on. We haven't the time to waste on them.
Excuse me, Flyboy. I thought this was supposed to be an open forum. Seems to me your Zentradi buddies are the only ones allowed to participate. And frankly, that makes me a little suspicious. For all we know, these space apes might still be working for the enemy.
I've heard about enough out of you, Captain.
Enough bickering, gentlemen. Please, this is supposed to be a diplomatic mission. It might be helpful if we practice some diplomacy amongst ourselves. Oh, arguments are a waste of precious time and energy. Personally, I believe the problem of the Robotech Masters can be resolved through purely peaceful means, and I expect to make that my top priority. We'll resume this briefing after I've made my broadcast to the personnel on board the ship. Now, if you'll excuse me.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
All stations stand by. The channel is now open for priority communication from mission leader.
Greetings, fellow members of the Robotech Defense Force. I am Dr. Lang, leader of this mission. The process of assembling a crew to man the rebuilt SDF-3 has already begun. By tomorrow, we will have selected most of the crew members and additional personnel who will be coming with us on this attempt to reach a very distant planet. Homeworld of the Robotech Masters. Many of you were brought to this repair station specifically to become a part of this expedition to deep space. Welcome. Others may need to prove they've acquired the discipline and flexibility that will make them valuable to us as support personnel or fighter pilots to operate the Robotech weapons. We have no idea what sort of reception awaits us on the home world of these alien beings, but we are ready for any eventuality.
That is more than can be said for the inhabitants of Tyrol, who even now are calmly going about their daily business, totally unaware of the relentless inhuman horde that is bearing down on their capital city.
There, I finished the last of my experiments. I can't do anything more until we've secured one of these inorganics for study. Are you ready to go, Rem?
I'm having a little trouble here. Get off of me! Cabell, what's happened to these things all of a sudden? Come back here! I'm not sure how these little monsters fit into your experiments, but I'm starting to wonder if we wouldn't be better off by eating them for supper.
They have a biogenetic link to the flower of life. The presence of the Invid is disturbing to them.
Then the sooner we find a way to stop the Invid, the better. These things are driving me mad. Our sensors last picked them up around here somewhere. Perhaps they've moved on. But it doesn't sense our presence. Now's our chance.
No, Lem. I want one of the others. One of the cat-like droids.
I hope we catch one of them and not vice versa.
I'm getting a very distinct impression that our progress is being observed.
Yes, I was about to say the same thing myself.
Perhaps our behavior is puzzling them. They probably expect us to run in terror.
Well, they didn't stay puzzled very long. Where is it?
There! Run!
Cabell!
for just a moment. Ow!
To get away. That did it. That ought to hold him for a bit.
Yes, but only a bit. Seem to have much choice.
Right, here we go!
Lucky thing this troop carrier happened to be here.
Hang on! I've got to help him. That could be just what I'm looking for. Maybe I can turn this invid weaponry to my advantage. Now to find the power switch. Maybe.
It's beginning to break through. Great Thor. It's uncanny. Canopy won't keep it out for long. Such strength. Remarkable.
I wonder what's happened to Rem. Where did that boy get to?
Extraordinary. An invid shock trooper saved my life.
Hello, Cabell. All safe and sound up there? You didn't really think I'd abandon you, did you?
Rem, you amaze me.
I amaze myself. Come on, let's hurry up and get this specimen back to the lab before any others arrive.
My boy, we found no trace of the Flower of Life anywhere. But that's impossible, you idiot. This is the home world of the Robotech Masters. It must be here somewhere. Scan the entire planet. We have my language.
Congratulations, husband. Once again, you have impressed us all with your supreme stupidity.
I don't like your tone.
I told you the Robotech Masters were too clever to maintain the protoculture factory in their own backyard.
Silence, woman.
If you hadn't been so desperate to prove yourself a great warrior, we might have sent spies to find where they've taken you.
Are you forgetting who got us into this predicament in the first place? I'm not the one who fell under the spell of Zor and allowed him to steal our Flower of Life.
Must you keep harping on that? It happened a long time ago. Since then, I have evolved, while you've remained the spoiled child you always were.
Yes, you've evolved into a pathetic imitation of Zor's race.
Perhaps so, but that's preferable to being an incompetent, petty tyrant. I'm returning to Upterra. Goodbye.
Stop! I forbid you to go!
Don't provoke me, you spineless little anachronism!
Wait!
I've staged this little demonstration, Harry, to show you the progress we've made with these smaller Vertec fighters.
Sterling here, the Alpha handled the last sequence beautifully. No sign of stress on the hull.
Fine, Max. The prototype looks good so far. Now comes the real test. Max, Karen, move yourselves into position and stand by for trans-talking maneuver.
Roger.
We're on our way.
You're awfully quiet, Harry. Is something wrong?
You know, I didn't want Karen participating in this test.
What was I supposed to do, Harry? Refuse her my permission? Don't forget, she volunteered, and she happens to be one of the very finest test pilots we've ever had.
But I don't want my daughter to be a test pilot, Emil. I want her to be a scientist.
Control,
We are in position at T-Niner Delta, standing by to disengage and assume battleoid mode.
All right, Lieutenant. Proceed with the maneuver.
First phase of the maneuver complete. We are ready to attempt docking sequence.
You know this procedure's only been done in laboratory simulations.
And every time the Alphas have performed the maneuver perfectly.
Proceeding with phase two, we are exchanging positions and preparing to re-engage.
All systems are responding well.
Go to phase three.
Commencing. Securing Alpha from battleoid mode.
All right, I'll take mine in first, Karen. Reverse impulse boosters at 175.
That was absolutely perfect, Max. One of the smoothest link-ups I've ever had the pleasure of witnessing.
Okay, Karen, it's up to you. Steady now. Easy.
There's a problem with the link-up. My reverse boosters are shorting out.
She must abort the link-up and try again.
The docking gear's not responding.
Blow you loose, Karen. Pull up. Come on, pull up.
Max, do something! You've got to help her!
If that Alpha hits the atmosphere going at that speed, the whole thing will tear apart! Karen, you've got to at least try and get it stabilized! Good girl, you did it! Now maybe we can slow you down!
I suppose you have a plan, Commander.
I wouldn't be here if I didn't have a plan.
Good, that makes me feel a lot better.
Now try to extend your landing flaps. Create as much drag as you can. Boy, this fantail of yours, it's a mess. No wonder you had a problem. Now hang on, I'm kicking us into reverse.
He did it, Doctor. She's regaining control of the ship.
My manual stabilizers are coming on.
Good.
I owe you my life, Commander.
Well, you can buy me dinner and we'll call it even.
Karen, thank goodness you're safe. That little escapade nearly gave me a heart attack.
Well, if you were scared, imagine how I felt. I'm still shaking.
This proves once and for all you have no business being a test pilot.
Oh, Papa. I happen to believe I handled myself like a true professional, considering the circumstances.
I'll say she did. Look, Dr. Penn, it wasn't your daughter's fault that the link-up was unsuccessful. You should take a look at the fantail on that Alpha. It must have been bent out of shape on the transport that brought it up here. Nobody could have flown it any better. Frankly, it's a miracle she's still in one piece.
I'm sure you mean well, Commander, but all this is beside the point.
You know he's right, Papa. You just won't admit it.
Perhaps he is right. It makes no difference.
Excuse me, but I'd hate to see your daughter's talents go to waste. All I can say is she impressed me, and I'm a hard man to impress, Dr. Penn.
Well, I am not impressed. I've other plans for you. Karen!
Karen, a moment if you don't mind.
You gonna bite my head off too?
Calm down. I was impressed with your performance today.
You really mean it?
I'm going to recommend you as a combat pilot for the expedition.
Oh, thank you.
Just a minute. Don't you think you're overstepping your authority a little bit?
I'm sorry, Harry, but your daughter is old enough to make up her own mind. You can't hold on to them forever, my friend. Besides, if this mission should meet a hostile reception on Tyrol, we're going to need every able-bodied pilot we can lay our hands on.
Rick Hunter finds his time filled with preparations for two radically different but equally important events. The launch of the Expeditionary Force and his wedding to Lisa Hayes.
I hope Max is in. I want to hear how those pilot exams went. Uh-oh. Hi, Maria. Is Max around?
Well, speak of the devil. Come in here, mister. There's something you ought to see. Well, what do you think?
Pardon me, but isn't it bad luck to see your fiancé in her wedding dress before the wedding?
Rick, you don't believe that superstition. Besides, I'm not in my dress. I'm standing behind it.
Oh.
Show some respect, mister. Oh. Tension.
Sorry about that.
Impending marriage is no excuse for relaxing discipline.
Hi.
I beg your pardon, General. Aren't you exceeding your authority?
I can't help myself, ma'am. So take away my stripes, throw me in the brig, but please, not until the honeymoon's over.
We'll consider it. Sometimes I can't tell whether it's a marriage or a court-martial.
Tesla, you are my master scientist. Tell me what you know. Is this moon as worthless as it seems?
I have yet to find any trace of the Flower of Life, and most of the population is too old and sickly to serve as slave labor. I'm afraid there's very little use to us here.
Perhaps it will simply take more digging before we are able to find it. Come, Tesla, there is something I wish to discuss with you.
Yes, my lord.
Just because the Regis is somewhat more highly evolved than I am, she treats me as though I just crawled out of the swamp. I fear she'll try to undermine my authority. That's why this mission must succeed.
I understand.
I'm placing you in charge of the search for the Flower of Life. You're the only one that I trust, Tesla. The inorganics will be your eyes and ears. Use them to uncover the secrets of this place.
If this world holds any clue as to the whereabouts of the Flower of Life, I swear I will find it, my lord.
See that you do. Bring me what I seek, Tesla, and I will make you master of your own planet. Fail, and I will leave you to rot on this ball of dust for all eternity.
The time has come to strike a decisive blow against the Tyresians.
Precisely. That's why I had you program the living computer to coordinate an all-out assault on their capital. I'll bring them to their knees and force them to tell me where they've hidden the Flower of Life.
The computer has formulated the plan of attack. Leave everything to me. However, if I may make a suggestion, my lord, we might be more likely to find what we seek by discovering the whereabouts of the thief who stole it from us. Find the flagship of the Robotech Master Zor, and we will find the Flower of Life.
You really expect me to go searching for a ship that could be halfway across the universe?
I have estimated that such a journey would drain considerably less energy from your reserves than this assault on the planet below, my lord.
That may be, but nevertheless, we will proceed with the attack. I have already ordered our transports and gunships to abandon their positions in the outlying sectors and mobilize over the Tyresian capital. If I am to be frustrated by this pathetic little planet, then my revenge will be swift and terrible.
Rick, here's the progress report from Max. He says he selected nearly 70% of the troops we'll need for the expedition. If it keeps going this well, he should be finished by tomorrow morning.
Good. It sounds like everything's moving along right on schedule. Looks to me like our problems are pretty much behind us.
Except for Colonel Edwards. I'm afraid he might end up being a problem.
But Edwards has been with us since we began.
The man kind of plays his own game. His ambition seems to be more important to him than the mission.
You have some evidence to support this?
Nothing concrete. I just don't trust him. There's something about him that ain't right.
Well, Vince, it's too late for him to do much damage to us now.
I'm not so sure. If something does happen, just remember I warned you.
I'm concerned about you. If I didn't know you better, I'd suspect you were bucking for a promotion. But if that ever happened, you'd be miserable. Huh? You wouldn't have time to worry about my problems.
From this star chart, and assuming that the value of N remains constant, extrapolate the following.
The best course from X to Y. Let me see. If you multiply the vector by the hyperspace factor and divide by... Wait, I don't remember what my vector's supposed to be.
B. You have chosen B. That is incorrect.
Hey, stop putting words in my mouth. Yeah, come in. It's open.
I assume you're Jack Baker.
That's right.
With the Major General's compliments. It's to the wedding tomorrow. Everyone on board's invited.
Cadet Baker, shall we continue the exam now? Cadet Baker, my thermosensors detect your presence in the room. Please respond.
I got an invite to the General's wedding. Huh? Sorry for the rough treatment. Hope to see you soon aboard the STF-3.
It would seem your prospects are good, Cadet Baker. Nonetheless, you are going to have to finish this exam.
Say, Rick, I don't mean to pry, but is anything the matter? People are saying you've been acting kind of moody the last couple of days.
Matter? What could be the matter?
Well, you got an excuse. It is the day before your wedding, after all.
This won't hurt a bit.
I'm just a little tired, that's all. It's exhausting having to supervise everything.
All right, next.
If nobody's ever been to the Phantoma system before, how do they know what to immunize us against? One of my many questions. You're right, Max. Something is the matter. But it's not the wedding.
What then?
Or should I say it's not just the wedding? Every day I'm reminded of the enormity and importance of this expedition. Maybe it's too much for one man to be responsible for.
Now don't start about how you're the youngest general in the history of the RDF, and about how you don't deserve it. You may be the youngest, but you also happen to be one of the best.
The best and the brightest. That's me all over, isn't it, Max?
Excuse me.
Colonel Edwards, what the...
General, it's come to my attention that you have expressed serious doubts as to my abilities as commander of the ground forces on this mission. I had hoped you'd come to me with any doubts you might have had, instead of discussing them with everyone else on board.
Colonel, calm down. Nobody's questioning your personal abilities. I'm surprised you'd let rumors like that upset you.
I'm sorry, but when I hear people questioning my competence and even my loyalty, I can't help but be a little upset.
For what it's worth, I have complete faith in you, Colonel Edwards.
Well, then, as long as that's understood, I do the best I can with the meager resources left to me, and I don't appreciate all this talking behind my back. Good day, sir.
There, you see what I mean, Max? A couple of weeks ago, that paranoid schmo wouldn't have dreamed of talking to me in that tone of voice. But now look at me, I'm Rick Hunter, everyone's doormat.
Enough self-pity, you've got the command you've always wanted. And you're about to get married. We should all have such problems. Come on, snap out of it.
I wish I could, Max. I wish I could.
Oh, Rick, it's all so hopeless. How long did we think we could go on kidding ourselves? Closing our eyes to the fact that you love Min-Mae.
No, I don't. I mean, yes, I do. I mean, I love you, Lisa.
So long, Rick.
No! Lisa!
You can't love us both.
Lisa! Oh, Lisa, despite the way it seemed, it was always you. Always. Min-Mae.
I hope you two will be very happy. I really do. I guess this is goodbye. Goodbye, Rick. Don't worry about me. I'll be fine. Really, I will.
I'm sorry, Min-Mae. I'm sorry. Your heart was always so full of love. Was there any room left for forgiveness?
Penny for your thoughts.
Is that all they're worth?
A nickel?
It bothers me that while we're all out chasing some crazy dream, the Earth will be almost defenseless.
It's not crazy. If we succeed, we'll be ensuring the Earth's safety, maybe forever.
I know. I'm not as mixed up as I sound. It's just all happening so fast, the mission and getting married the morning before we leave.
Oh, so that's what's bothering you. Don't forget you had 9 years to prepare for this mission, not to mention our marriage. Don't tell me you're getting cold feet now.
Of course not, Lisa.
Following pilot and deck are to report to the simulator room at 0800 for final evaluation. Baker, Jack.
This is it, Jack. The chance of a lifetime. Don't blow it.
Problems and frustrations of a handful of humans has little meaning when seen in context with the major crisis facing the citizens of Tyrol. The situation is simple. Design a defense adequate to save the planet from destruction at the hands of a superior force. The solution is not as easily discovered. Trial and error does have its limitations, especially when there is no time for second chances.
I don't understand, Cabell. Why do we have these poor creatures hooked up to the samples we took from that invid contraption?
I'm certain these little animals have some special biogenetic relationship with the invid. Observe their response as the current passes through those samples.
Amazing! The feedback from the process sends the little monsters into an absolute frenzy. There certainly seems to be a connection. Might they be what the invid came here looking for?
The alarm! The invid must be attacking the capital!
We've got to warn them!
enough. How about trying to be a grown-up for a few minutes? Is that too much to ask?
The curtain's about to go up.
Here.
I'm an expert when it comes to these things. There. It's a matter of finesse.
Thanks a lot, Max. I guess I'm just a little clumsy this morning.
You're lucky to have me for a best man.
I'm grateful.
Oops. Well, hey, maybe you'll start a trend.
You know, this all reminds me of how Rick and I were married once.
Is that right? And does Lisa know this?
It was all make-believe, of course. We were just kids. One day we got lost below decks on the STF-1. We thought we might never be found.
We've just got to face it. We'll live our entire lives here in this ship. I'll never know what it's like to walk down the aisle as a bride.
Minbei.
What?
You will. I'll help you.
How are you going to do that?
Well, we could do it right here. We could pretend.
Okay. Then you really mean it? Then let me borrow your scarf. This might be the only veil I ever get to wear in my life. What do you think?
Minmay, you look beautiful. I guess I should be the groom, huh? Okay. Is this what we do next?
Rick, why doesn't someone come and find us? I've got to get home!
But you will, I promised you.
I'm just so scared.
I know, so am I. Come on, I'm telling you, we're gonna get out of here. There's got to be a way. We can't give up. We've got to keep trying. I've never been a quitter, and you shouldn't be one either.
Stop it. That's all just silly talk. You know what's really going to happen. We're never going to get out of here. There's no chance.
Minmay, it's not silly talk. I really mean it. We can get out of here if we don't give up. You mustn't give up. I'm doing my best. I'm sorry.
No, Rick. I'm the one that should apologize. It's just, well... Oh, Rick!
Come on, it'll be all right.
Rick, I've been so stupid.
That's not true.
Kiss me, Rick.
If you want.
I can't stop myself from thinking about what might have been.
It's over. It's all ancient history.
Yes, I suppose.
Defenses will never be able to stop them. We've got to abandon the lab to keep your research from falling into their hands.
I've already devised our escape route. A code was programmed into the computer, opening a pathway to the catacombs below.
Do we stay down here till the Invid leave?
Till they leave? You're an optimist, my boy.
Thank you. Just look at them, Cabell. They destroy our homeworld and march through the capital unopposed. It's humiliating.
But inevitable, with the Robotech masters away from the planet.
We'll make the Invid pay for this somehow.
If we survive.
My lord, scanners still show negative on all fronts. You've scanned the capital and you're sure there's nowhere else the Tyresians might be hiding the Flower of Life.
Negative, my lord. We would have detected even the slightest trace.
Very well. I wash my hands of this wretched planet. Tesla, blasted to atoms.
Ask me my reason. Should we exterminate this species before they've told us everything they know?
Good point. Have your units round up any survivors they come across and prepare them for an inquisition. We shall see if we can persuade them to tell us where the Robotech Masters have taken the Flowers of Life. I shall descend and conduct the inquisition myself. Inform me when you have secured the planet.
Understood, my lord. It won't be long now.
Bringing more prisoners in? These monsters must want us smothered alive.
Shh, calm down, they'll hear you.
You, invader, what do you want from us?
You know very well what I want. The Flower of Life. Tell me where it is.
Never!
Culture Tell me your insignificance in the world.
He speaks the truth. We know nothing. We're but simple old men. The masters never told us of such things.
My friend, I believe you. Enforcer, reward these citizens for their honesty. And watch that!
Huh? Oh. It appears to be some kind of timing mechanism. What does it mean?
It means our doom.
The Invid history books will write of the inevitability of the Invid victory in the battle for the Robotech Master's homeworld. However, it is a day that historians from a different world will write about in a very different context. For the survivors of the first Robotech War, this day will be remembered as the culmination of a romance that was born in battle and ended in a voyage to the unknown. It is the day that Rick Hunter finally marries Lisa Hayes.
Look at that. It's a packed house.
Well, Max, let's move. Don't want to keep them waiting, do we? Oh, brother, I give up.
don't know, Janice. I may not be able to make it through the ceremony.
Hang in there. We've got to sing afterwards.
Who is it that gives this bride away?
Sir, it is my honor to give this bride away.
Very well. Will you please approach your bride-to-be? We are gathered here to join together this man and this woman in the bonds of matrimony. This is a special moment that will live forever in the hearts and minds of all those assembled here today. Rick Hunter, do you take this woman to be your wife?
I do.
Lisa Hayes, do you take this man to be your husband?
I do.
My friends, you are both shining examples for us all. Your marriage will be a union of devotion and love. And just as this ring shall endure, so shall the bond that is between you. Rick, repeat after me. This ring is a symbol of my love.
This ring is a symbol of my love.
Now say to her the words, with this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
And place it on her finger. By the power invested in me by the Supreme Council of the United Earth Government, I now pronounce you man and wife. It's customary to kiss the bride, if I'm not mistaken.
A shot of you in the cake. I know. Let's get one of you feeding your husband a piece. Oh, yeah, that's real cute. Fabulous.
Why wait in line when I can just help myself?
Oh, no, you don't.
Hey, what's your problem? Give it back to me.
Listen, Bully, I've had my eye on this piece of cake all
the time. Yeah, but I got here first.
Give me it.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, a special surprise for you. Min May and Janice have agreed to sing for us.
Min May came in spite of everything. I'm so glad she's chosen to be our friend. I'm sure this can't be easy for her.
She's a very special person.
Close by the candlelight. It's all because tonight's the night. Now hold my hand and take this ring.
Time.
asking you two this, but what sort of wedding gift do you get somebody who's flying off to the other side of the universe?
This must be the biggest reception we've ever played.
Hello there. Hmm? You sang beautifully.
Oh, thank you.
The name's Wolf. Do you know how long I've wanted to meet you?
No, try humming a few bars. Oh, I'm sorry. You were talking to Minmay, not me. Excuse me.
Don't mind Janice. She has a very odd sense of humor. Oh, I think I see someone I got to talk to. So long.
Having a good time, sir?
Yes, Karen, but I hope you're not enjoying yourself too much.
Why is that?
Your preliminary training starts at 5 tomorrow morning.
Oh, do I get a wake-up call?
You're the one who wanted to be a pilot.
Allow me. I'm pretty handy with hardware.
Cadet Penn, meet Cadet Baker.
The pleasure is 90% mine.
Thanks.
Don't mention it. You can just consider me at your service.
Oh, I couldn't do that.
Suit yourself, but you're missing a great opportunity. So long.
He's one of your pilots?
Mm-hmm. He's a bit of a hotshot.
That's the sort of person that you'll be wasting your time with from now on.
I'm not so sure it's a waste of time. There's something about him.
Hey, Bowie, it tastes better in your tummy than splattered all over your face, doesn't it?
Oh, be quiet.
Well, the time's come for me to toss out the bridal bouquet. It's the moment you've all been waiting for, girls. If any of you hopes to remain single, I suggest you stay out of the line of fire. Here goes. See you all after the honeymoon.
Yeah, about 5 hours from now. Come on.
Oh. Amazing. They finally did it. Pinch me. I think I'm dreaming.
It's over. Now I've got to get on with the rest of my life. Goodbye, Rick.
My husband's ignorance and stubbornness are enough to drive me mad. He is in every way my intellectual and spiritual inferior, a de-evolutionized barbarian. And yet his will is strong. When I am with him, I feel his mind reaching out to me, trying to smother me. He is jealous of my evolutionary achievements and would pull me down to his level. That is why I have returned to Upterra, the homeworld of our civilization, in order to free my mind of his influence. Now I see the path I must take. No longer will I be subservient to the Regent. The time has come to act on my own. If the invid flower of life is to be found, then I am the one who will find it. Not by blasting some insignificant little world into dust, but by tracking down the flagship of the Robotech Master Zor. I will go to Hadon 5 and activate the sensor nebula. No matter where Zor's ship may be, even though it lies beyond the farthest fringe of the cosmos, the sensor nebula will find it. Then at last, I will take the flower back from the thief who betrayed me. And woe to anyone who would stand in my way.